What's going on, everybody? Game one of the Stanley Cup Final started yesterday. Montreal versus Tampa Bay. Great goalie matchup between Carey Price and Andrei Vasilevskiy. Today, I want to go over three of my favorite saves that I saw in game one, starting with this save from Carey Price. Makes it look easy from a point shot. Great use of shot lane recognition. So let's take a look at this first clip. Pretty basic save from Carey Price, makes it look easy, but what I want everybody to notice is that he does a great job of recognizing the lane as the play develops. So we'll see here, the puck gets moved to the point here and then gets moved directly across to the other defenseman on the opposite side. Tampa Bay has players in front of the net here and here, so you know they're trying to get traffic in front of the net as this puck travels towards the net for a scoring chance. So we'll put this in slow motion for everybody. Puck goes up to the point here, directly across, and as you can see here, we have one, two, three Tampa Bay players all heading right towards the net here, trying to create some sort of havoc and traffic for Carey Price, so maybe there's a deflection or some sort of tip happening, to try to get the puck to the net and try to score. So as this play develops, it gets moved across. Carey recognizes that we have a right-handed shooter on the right side of the point here. So most likely as he receives this puck, this lane is gonna go open up on this short side here, and this lane is gonna go right towards the net here. So Carey Price sees that and recognizes it, and he notices that there is a Montreal player here, his own teammate, that there's no chance for any sort of tip play to happen here like the first goal was scored. He recognizes that, so he predicts that this play is going to get thrown right to the net here and try to create some sort of scoring situation. So Price does a good job of recognizing this, gets to his spot in his crease, and then makes a simple blocking save. So as this puck gets thrown, all he has to do is slide into it and make an easy save, a blocking save. So watch this one more time. Puck gets D to D. Lane starts to open up. Right here is your lane. So all Price has to do is just sit at the top of his crease, wait for this puck to get to the net, and just easily shift into that puck, right? Sealing up all holes, nothing through his arms here and here. Very simple. Blocking save, doesn't do anything crazy with his hands, doesn't reach out for it. All he has to do is make himself big in case there is a tip and a player gets a stick on it, making sure all the holes are sealed through his arms here, but also making himself big. But recognizing that lane as this play starts to develop is a great skill to have, and being a good example of being one step ahead as the play develops. Let's take a look at this second save from Carey Price. Big save and a big time in the game. Steven Stamkos left wide open in the middle of the zone. Carey Price does a great job of getting to the top of his crease, cutting out time and space. So let's take a look at this. That's a great angle and view of the save here. Let's watch it one more time in real speed. All right, so a little bit of a defensive breakdown here for Montreal. Puck gets moved up the wall. We have five Montreal players on the same side of the ice. One, two, three, four, and five. Stamkos somehow gets left wide open. Last person you'd want to be wide open taking this shot. But I want to watch how Carey Price here show everybody how he gets to the top of a crease and really cuts away time and space and gives Stamkos no chance to really put the puck where he wants to put it and makes him shoot where Price wants him to shoot. As this puck travels across, easy glove save from Price. Let's take a look at this replay angle so you can see what I'm talking about here. So as this puck moves across here, you can see as Stamkos is receiving this puck, the momentum of him receiving it and the way he's skating, he's heading in this direction, and Price recognizes that. So as soon as this puck gets over to him, Price quickly gets to the top of his crease and gets his feet set, knowing that as his momentum travels this way, all Price has to do is make himself big, get his feet set, and just take this foot here on the short side and start to shift it in this direction here. So as this play happens, you see the momentum of the puck. All he has to do is make this shift. As he's shifting, he lowers this blocker here, eliminating any chance of a far side post and shot, which for a right-handed shooter, that's a pretty difficult shot to drag this puck across and try to go post in here. And Price recognizes that. So as he shifts this foot, he makes himself big, gets lower, and really is forcing him to shoot right where Price wants him to shoot, which is short side here, glove side. And all he has to do is lift his glove and puts it in great position to make a very big save and a big moment in the game here. But this is a great recognition from Price and being one step ahead and recognizing momentum, recognizing the hand of the shooter and putting himself in a good position to force a shooter to shoot where he wants him to shoot. Last clip of the video here, great save by Andre Vasilevskiy. Same point as the last clip with Carey Price, forcing the shooter and cutting out time and space for him to pick a spot and really forcing the shooter to shoot where Vasilevskiy wants him to shoot. So let's take a look at this clip. Okay, one more time. Save there. Let's fast forward to the replay of the save. It gives you a little bit of a better angle. All right, so that's the best view, in my opinion, on this save here, and really shows the point I'm trying to make here. So as this play heads into the zone, gets passed to the side, and we see all of a sudden time and space open up for the Montreal player. Vasilevskiy sees this. As this play starts to develop, we'll put it in slow motion here. As this play starts to develop, he recognizes that this guy trying to drive to the net is taken out of the play by the defenseman here, so he is no longer an option. So it's really just the shooter and Vasilevskiy coming right in, trying to score this goal. So as this play develops, he goes and releases this shot. Pretty routine save by Vasilevskiy, but there's really a little bit more to it here. As he catches this puck, he sees he's a right-handed shooter coming down the left side. He knows that far side is really where this player wants to go. So what does Vasilevskiy do? He holds strong, top of the crease. He's a big goalie. So he holds his feet to the top of the crease, makes himself big, making this far side shot very difficult, really forcing the shooter to try to pick a hole somewhere and forcing him to drag this puck to the inside and try to go short side, which is the least probable angle for a goal and exactly where Vasilevskiy wants him to shoot. So by making himself big, picking a good spot in the crease and not over anticipating the shot, putting himself in a bad spot, maybe being over here, he puts himself in a good spot at the top of the crease, forcing the Montreal player to shoot right into his pad, and all Vasilevskiy has to do is just release into the shot and make an easy low pad save. So as this play comes, he pull, drag, shoots, makes a real easy save there. So by making himself big, all he has to do is just force this player to take this shot. And he sees as he drags this puck, Vasilevskiy already knows what he's going to try to do, or at least the most likely outcome of this is he's going to try to go and beat him short side here because he's making himself big. So as he drags this puck, he already knows where this puck is going to go. And all he has to do is just release right into it and make an easy pad save.